Keith Hilson with the Trombone Chop at Schmidt Music. You know, one of the things I really love about my job is all of the opportunities I get to, you know, try out and to see and to hold and to play really, really great instruments. You know, these are instruments that not only play phenomenally, but you can just tell the amount of care and handcraftsmanship that go into them. You know, a lot of times unique designs that you don't really see anywhere else. And I think these trombones certainly qualify for that. These are our brand new Lawler trombones. So for those of you who are not familiar with Lawler trombones, Roy Lawler is a custom brass maker out of Flat Creek, Tennessee. He's been building for quite a few years. Had started with trumpets and trombones. He's kind of left the trumpets aside and really now is just focused on small bar tenor trombones. And a lot of people really like his instruments because they're extremely handcrafted. It's really just one man, Roy Lawler, who's doing all of the work on the instruments. And there are a lot of little features with them, little details that people really like. So, again, Lawler trombones, these are just small bore tenor trombones. He has a lot of different options available within them. So he has different slide setups. He offers, you know, 500, 508 bores, dual bore 500, 508 bores, different slide configurations, lightweight nickel silver crooks or yellow brass crooks. One of his preferred setups is actually lightweight yellow brass with that. He's got he's got a couple of different bell setups available. So one of the things Lawler is really, really known for with a lot of folks are the detachable bell flares. So we see this now in the trombone community that there are a lot of different companies who are working with this concept of the detachable bell flares. For a lot of folks, it's primarily about portability. You know, able to pack the instrument into a much smaller case makes it more transport friendly, but there are a few makers who have been playing around with the concept of different bell flare materials compared to the bell stem. And really, Lawler was one of the first to really start exploring these ideas. And so he's got this idea where he's got two different bell stems, a little bit longer and a little bit shorter one, depending on the amount of feedback you want, the response you're looking for, different materials available in the bell stem, but also in the bell flare. He offers, you know, three different materials in a variety of different thicknesses, gauges, in three different, or you know, a variety of different widths, anywhere from 7 inch to 8 inch width, so that you can really kind of further customize the instrument to what you are looking for in terms of the sound. You know, other little features. One of the things I really like here, and it's a little thing, but I really like the tenon collar here. So we know with a lot of the collars, they're, you know, just a oval type collar just in place. With his design, he calls it kind of an Art Deco design where it actually fits in flush with the cork barrel right here. It's a little feature, but it looks great. It feels really great. Another thing that he's done is he's eliminated the need for a counterweight here by kind of overbuilding the ferrules here. So we've got heavier ferrules right here, which still provide you the counterbalance, but you don't have the weight sitting here instead. You know, obviously they're very striking looking instruments as well. A lot of people really like the brush finish he gives with this, but of course, obviously the big selling point has got to be the playability here. So I'm gonna play for you on a couple of different configurations so you can hear, you know, this in action and hear those different bell flares in action. So I'm gonna start off with a 508 slide here. Yellow brass stem, and I'm going to start off with a gold brass bell flare, 8 inch gold brass bell flare, and then I'm going to switch to an 8 inch yellow brass bell flare. So you can see here even the little differences between those two. Thank you. you know, I'm trying out, or you know, people are playing around with different material combinations, is how much just a little change can affect not only the sound, but really the response and the control. For me, I really noticed, you know, first off, obviously a sonic difference between the gold brass and the yellow brass here. You know, as we might expect, I found the gold brass to be, you know, a little bit warmer, a little bit broader. For me, I felt kind of throughout the ranges, it was actually a little bit more open as well. I felt like the upper range on the yellow brass maybe slotted in just a little bit easier. And as a quick side note, that's one of the reasons I really love the Lawlers all the way through, is these are one of the few small bore tenors I found that I feel like really actually slot in that 11th, 12th partial, you know, getting up in, you know, the Ds, the E-flats, E-naturals, Fs. I feel like it actually locks in there versus just kind of an approximation of it, which I think is really cool. But I felt like the yellow brass did actually lock in a little bit better there. Obviously had a little bit more projection with it. There were certain times though where I felt like, it closed down. It did, it, maybe because it was responding quicker and I was using a little bit different air. It's hard to say, but the point of it is that, you know, we have a lot of options with this, and that's how the Lawlers are designed. So his standard package comes with, you know, your slide setup, your, you know, bell stem setup, whatever's working for you, and two different bell flares so that you can mix and match. A lot of times what he recommends, what I've been liking is, you know, say I maybe need a, you know, a bell to really give a lot of projection. Say I'm doing like a lot of salsa work or a lot of, you know, maybe lead big band work. I want to have something a little bit more tighter focused. Maybe I go with a little bit smaller bell, maybe like a yellow brass or something. But at the same time, maybe I'm doing like some small group work, or I'm doing like some big band section work, something else. I don't want to be sitting above the mix. I want to be blending a little bit more, or I want that little bit softer response. And changing up the bell flare alone can give you a lot of those options with it. So anyway, hope you enjoyed hearing about the Lawlers. Again, we're really, really excited about these. I love how they play. If you have any comments or questions about these at all, please feel free to leave them below in the comments here. Love to hear about your experience, or you know, anything you heard in the video here today. If you like the video, obviously think about giving us a thumbs up. If this is the first time you watched any of our videos on the Trombone Shop, think about subscribing. We're trying to create new regular content like this. We're very lucky that we've got a lot of these great instruments and accessories coming through. And so hopefully you have a chance to hear, see these in action. And as always, you can find us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter as well. Thanks as always for watching.